Musical, theater. Theater has always been closely associated with music, movement, and dance. For example, in early Greek theater, music was used to underscore the meaning of many of the lines delivered by the chorus. It is not until the 20th century, however, that we find a separate genre of theater known as musical theater. This is a type of theater that is actually a product of the United States. Experts believe that musical theater developed out of two specialized forms of theater, vaudeville and burlesque, which provided popular entertainment through most of the 1800s. Originally, burlesque featured dramatic sketches and songs that made fun of the legitimate theater. Vaudeville was always filled with music and other variety acts, including acrobatics and comedy scenes, but had more of a tone suitable for family entertainment. The popular musical theater of today actually started by accident. In 1866, the New York production of a melodrama entitled The Black Crook decided at the last moment that their play was not ready to open. At the same time, a theater where a ballet was to open burned to the ground. In a frantic attempt to save both productions, the dancers from the ballet were added to the plot of The Black Crook, and the show opened. The resulting production was so successful that producers began to create new productions that combined fully staged dance numbers with fully developed plots. Musical theater was born. Audiences loved musical theater. Star performers such as George M. Cohan and composers such as Irving Berlin and George Gershwin specialized in this new form of theater. These new musicals had a uniquely American perspective of the world and expressed and supported the nation's growing sense of nationalism around the time of World War I in a way that no other medium could. For example, Cohen's Yankee Doodle Dandy and Over There, as well as Grand Old Flag, played a great role in keeping American spirits up before and during the years of World War I. At first, the plot lines for musicals were little more than frameworks to hold the musical numbers together. In the late 1920s, however, musical plots became much more structurally sound. These new plots usually consisted of modern, humorous stories. Some of the most popular musicals written during these years were by Rodgers and Hart and Lerner and Lowe. By 1943, when the musical Oklahoma opened in New York, the theater was in the golden age of the American musical. During the years after 1940, the musicals dealt with a wide variety of subject matter, from the life of Annie Oakley in Annie Get Your Gun to Shakespeare in Kiss Me, Kate. As time passed, the musical's plot content began to change. In the late 1960s, many musicals became more like musical revues, which feature many songs with little, if any, dialogue. The rock musical Hair, staged in 1967, was built around a theme more than it was built around a unified story. These non-story motivated musicals became known as concept musicals. The 1980s began an era of musicals with large casts and elaborate sets called mega musicals. These musicals became famous for their spectacular special effects, such as a helicopter landing on stage in Miss Saigon. Today, many different types of musical theater are performed all over the world, and the genre continues to grow and change.